Hey everybody, it's CyberGwar. What's going on? How are my favorite people doing today? I bought a C2 Hercules Starlifter. Damn,
she's big. She's a big one.
Makes me a lot of money. And I want to take you guys on one of my favorite little routes. I figured I'd share it because I make good money with it. Let's hope everything goes good in this video. You never know what you're going to get when you get out there. You may get attacked. You may not have any inventory. But we're going to give it a shot. I make this route a lot. I try and do it late at night when there's less people on. But hey, we're going to go out there and do it. My home base is Area 18, so this is usually where I start the route. But you can also start this route at Orison. You'll see during the video why. But either Area 18 or Orison, you start there. It's a quick route. Literally, most places you might have to stop one way would be two places. You stop at one place, you can't fill up there. There's a second alternative place you can go to fill up the rest of the cargo area. So we're gonna go check it out though. I really don't know how much money I make. Let's see how much money I got now. 479-3182. 479-3182. All right, so I got 4,793,182 credits. We'll see how much I have by the end of this. I'll try to keep track of how much I spend too. I'm not good with the math. I like to just go out and see what I pull in at the end. But you'll see it. Oh, I got a repair. I got attack last night going on one of the areas in this route. I was able to jump away. I took a couple missiles though because I had my weapons turned off like an idiot, so I wasn't able to deploy countermeasures. So the ship's a little red. I had two people attack me on yellow. But I got out of there. As always, I'm very cautious and I always have an escape plan and I try to get out of there. As long as there's no quantum dampener, I'm usually pretty good. Is this the best route? No. Are you gonna make the most money on this route? Probably not, but it's a fun route. It's an easy route. You don't have long fly-ins and out of atmosphere, so getting away is pretty easy if you do become attacked. And they seem a little off the beaten path, kind of, but not. I don't know. Like, less people go to these areas to buy stuff to load up their Starlifters. Where are my guns not powering on here? There we go. I gotta fix the ship. Oh my god, it takes forever to frickin' fill the fuel in this thing. Alright, hydrogen's full. Quantanium next. Alright. Restock. I don't know why they have to restock in the ship, but it's restocking. Repair in progress. All right, we're ready. Let's hit the friendly skies, or unfriendly skies, depending on how the server goes. That's what I love about Star Citizen. You never know what's gonna happen when you start. You have all these plans to get started, and at any given moment, everything can go sideways. You know, you gotta hope for the best, but you know, best part is be paranoid, be cautious. This thing is so fast in atmosphere for its size, it's not even funny. She's got a lot of power. I want to upgrade the weapons on it, but I'm not quite sure what to upgrade to yet. It's got cannons on it at the moment. But everything else has been upgraded to military class 1. Or military class A. Grade A, whatever you want to call it. Okay, so let me get the planets in the map. If your planets don't show up in your map, just close the map and reopen it. Comes right back. So first stop, we're going to Laria. We're gonna go to Sail 5. I go to Sail 5 first, get everything I can there. If I can't get everything I need at Sail 5, I go to Sail 2 and load up there. with more. So if you can't get the optimal things, because we're looking for barrel, obviously, and I gotta jump to a poem. I'm looking for barrel and diamonds. Those are like the best things to get at these two locations. Oh, and a Grecium. They have a Grecium at sale too. You'll make good money on that as well. But they don't have a lot of it there, so it's not gonna fill up your ship. So I look at sale too as like my fill up recovery. Like if I can't fill up a sale 5, I go to sale 2 and hop off the ship there. If for whatever reason, sale 2 is empty, I just grab whatever and go and then start the whole round trip thing anyway. I might not make a lot on the first round, but coming back, I make good money going back to our corp. So I know a lot of traders go to sale 5, but they've been seeming to hang out at Hurston lately. So I haven't really had much of a problem at sale 5. Not saying it's always going to be available, but we're going to go see what kind of stock is there. Usually you can pick up like 500 skew of barrel and then the rest with diamond here. And if I can't fill it all the way up with those two, I'll head over to sale 2. I'll grab the Egresium and whatever else they have there. I can't think of it off the top of my head. You know me, I don't script these things out. I just go, I do. And then coming into sale 5, I stay up high, the top of the atmosphere. So if I do have to jump, literally just jump to that OM and get the heck out of here. All right, we already got a ship on the ground named Pineapple. Using a Star Runner. He poses no threat to this ship. I mean, he may try to attack me, you never know. But we'll see. Let's hope he's friendly. We can get in and get out. There's another ship there. Avenger Titan, huh? I'm not sure if Pineapple's in his ship or not or what, but we'll find out. He might just be at the pad loading up his ship with a ground vehicle, or he may be there trading. Not sure. Alright, the guy in the small ship parked on the small pad. That's good. A lot of traders try to avoid people, and normally I do, but hey, can't be scared of everybody all the time, you know? I'll give him some room in case he's bad at piloting, he can take off here. I always check my outside cameras before I get on the elevator. He hasn't targeted locked me yet, so... Oh, there's a dead body out there. I wonder if that's his ship. See if the guy's online. No, there's no Pineapple online. Okay, well, I don't know what's up. Someone's ship just sitting here. Before I get on the elevator, I always use my external camera to look for people hanging out who can jump on the elevator. I don't see anybody. Doesn't mean they're not there. Always be cautious. I'd rather have him try and get on here now. Oh, there's no comm array up here. Crap. Okay, well, be aware. Before I get off the elevator, I hit lower deck. So it goes right back up. It doesn't hang there for 30, 40 seconds. Nobody's inside here. That's good. I got my lights on, so it's kind of bright in here. All right, look at, we got 500 skew of barrel. It's 1.13. And then diamond. So I'm not going to fill up completely here. Now, if you wanted to, since there's only 113 ski left, you could pick up some of the stuff. But we're going to go over to the other place now. We're going to go to sale two because I'd rather get a higher profit margin. Diamonds aren't the best returns, but you get like 10%. So whatever, you know, what do we put in here? So we'll get 30,000 just from grabbing those diamonds. And we should get a couple hundred thousand from the barrel. But we're going to head over to sale two now. So what did I say we put in there? 1.13, 1.4777. Okay, so it's 1.477. Got an arrow down there. Not too worried about him either. It's the best thing about the C2 is you can take a lot of damage before you're actually out of it. No, man. Why you park on the big pad, dude? Oh, that's the remains of another ship. All right. Let's see if we can't angle it in here. God, there's a lot of broken ships here, huh? Don't know what's going on, but I don't want to be a part of it. Smaller pad that can fit on it perpendicular. Got a lot of cargo. Don't want to lose it now. I can't afford to lose another few million. I lost 2 million yesterday morning because of a 30K. 30K soon as I landed at Orison full of diamonds and barrel. It was about 2 million. Plus I had a ton of stuff I was going to sell there too. I probably had 25 of those Ombro suits. I had like collected them all. My T-shoes, biker jackets. So I was looking at where is the freaking thing? Why am I so confused? All this rubbish they leave lying around. We need to do something about the CAG. All this crap. Okay, there's one there. Why is there two of the same building? I don't know. It's probably behind this building. Nope. Oh, I'm used to parking on the big pad. That's why it's way over here. Yeah, so I had a 30K yesterday morning. 2 million worth of cargo. I was like, crap. Okay, 30K. I was already landed too, but I hadn't stored the ship yet. I was still in the ship. And finally got back online, got back into the same server. Ship was in a claim state, so I waited half an hour. Ship never returned to retrieve at Area 18. So I flew to Area 18. Because usually after 30K, your ship goes back to your home base and you can retrieve it. Alright, some Agresium. 109 million. Okay, or 109,000. And then I'm just going to fill up the rest with titanium. Since we're so close to full, 63 SKU of that. Alright. Is this an optimal load? No. But we're gonna make it work, right? What you gotta do as a trader, just take what you can get, plan for the best, and fear for the worst. Alright, man, all this junk. This is a freaking constellation. Yeah, so I flew out to Area 18 and still wasn't able to retrieve it. It was still in an unknown state, claim status only. So I logged out, went back in 4 hours, figured, hey, maybe, and nope, I had to claim this thing, and lost all the cargo, lost it, 2 million credits. So that was not fun, but hey, you just keep rolling. You gonna take those hits, man? It's part of doing business. And then the night before, I went down to SMO22 at Microtech, which I hate Microtech. I don't want to go there. It's such a long climb out. It's a longer climb out than going to Orison. It's like 10% longer. It's 11,000 meters to get out of atmosphere to jump. So you got a long climb out in a thick atmosphere in a big ship weighed down by tons of cargo. And you're super vulnerable. But I got down there and the idiot pirates, they showed up. So I'm like, well, I haven't loaded up yet. I'm like, what are they going to do? All they'll do is blow me up. So one of the idiots was in a Saber. The other one was in an Inferno. So I took off from the pad, full gun in it, straight for the Saber, because he was right off the front of my ship. I slammed into him, broke off his wing, and then I gunned it for getting out of the atmosphere, and the Inferno caught up to me, and he was just nailing me. Saber comes up, he starts launching missiles. I'm deploying countermeasures like crazy. None of the missiles are getting through, but he's chewing me up with that Gatling gun, you know? I think I got 6,500 meters out of atmosphere, or no, up from the ground before he finally finished me off. And I was just like, you guys are idiots, because I wasn't even full. I mean, if you're going to pirate someone, wait for them to fill up first. I mean, what's that all about? You know? And they're like, oh, you had boxes. I'm like, I didn't have anything on my ship, dude. There was nothing on my ship. Not a damn. Your box fell out of the ship. I'm like, yeah, those were my junk weapons that were in my weapons rack, you idiot. So, I mean, I don't mind being pirated, man. Make it interesting. Make it fun. Don't just come in, sit there, and then do nothing, and then like light everyone up. So, you know, I mean, technically I did attack them first, but I sat there for a good 8-9 minutes waiting for them to do something, and they were just sitting there hovering, looking at me. So I was like, screw it, let me take them out. If I'd have hit that Saber a little better, I would have taken him right out and my ship still would have been fine. But either way, I knew I was going to die. I didn't have anything to lose on board. I lost some crappy weapons that were in the weapons rack. And that was it. Not a big deal. And I actually went back and got my armor back because I had my body marker. And I went back. I looked. They found the box and they emptied it. But all that was in there was P4s and like a sniper rifle. So if that's what they really wanted, go for it. They left all my food in there and everything. All right, we're going to take this down to Orison. We're going to go sell it. And then we're going to hit the return trip to Area 18.
Welcome to the ASOP Vehicle Retrieval System.
As always, don't leave the ASAP terminal until it says stored. If you leave earlier than it being actually stored, you may actually lose your load.
Yeah, this must be my stop! Gonna go make my money!
I love Orison. I think next time I make a location to live, I'm gonna live here.
This is your stop. Please prepare to disembark.
I'm hoping it's super stable in patch 3.2.0, but we'll see. It's pretty stable now. I mean, there's no reason not to live here. And having the only reason I would have is that all the stuff I need for my org is at Area 18. At least my uniforms. But I could always go buy those and bring them back here. So it's not really a big deal. All right. We made it. Okay, here we go. Titanium 63 SKU. I don't remember what I paid for it, but I'm sure it was not a lot. We're going to see what the total is here on this run after I sell it all. 357k for the diamond. I'm not sure diamond gets the most money here, but we'll see. I started out with 4,793,182 credits. Alright, let's see what we made. So we started out with 4.793182. So I made just under 300,000 credits on that. Literally 500 credits away from 300,000. 532 credits away from 300,000. So it was 299,470 blah blah blahs. So 300k. It would have been better if there were more diamond when I went there. I would have made more credits, but hey, 300k for one way. And now we can start the second part of the journey, the round trip back to Area 18. All right, we're ready to start our second leg home. I love the paint on this thing. It changes colors from blue to black to gray, sometimes even green depending on the lighting. I don't know if that's intentional or not, but pretty damn cool. Or if it's just an effect of the lighting in the graphics renderer.
Please visit again.
All right, for the second leg home, there's two things you could do here. You could go to Selen and go to Hicks, or you can go to Yella and hit Beacons. I'm gonna go to Hicks today just to see what's going on there. To Hicks, there's a comma right here. We're in Armistice, so two pluses. Hope they have what we need. Always check the outside for stragglers wanting to board your ship. when you make the Hicks land, get in here. Oh man, there's a low supply of medical supply. Okay. Well, we might have to go over to Deacon's. It's gonna take about 10 minutes to refill this. Why is there so low? Man, maybe people discovered the medical supplies. 2,000 SKU of stims. Yeah, that's not gonna be a good run. We're gonna go over to Deacon's. It'd just be quicker to head over there than sitting here on the ground. Hoping no one shows up. I could be at Deacon's in 5 minutes. Instead of waiting 10 minutes here, you know? Time is money. Here we go. High inventory. So we're gonna fill up the rest. I didn't even catch how much I spent on this load, but whatever. We'll see how much we make. Thinking about maybe over a million. Here, let's see. Alright, according to the calculator machine, I spent 1.159 million. So 1.16. So, not bad. All for medical supplies. Then when you get to Area 18, you go and sell it. You got the TDD you can sell it at, and you can also sell it at the admin office. You can only sell a max of 500 at a time, so you're going to have to wait for the counter to reset once a tick, which is 10 minutes. But I usually go sell the 500, and then I run at the TDD, and then I run over to the admin office, and I usually am able to sell a little bit more. We made it. I can see I can sell 500 out of the 696 SKU. So we're gonna sell that. And like I say, you just have to wait a server tick, which is usually about 10 minutes. But I can actually go over to the admin office and sell a little bit more. And then as the timer ticks down too, it also allows for more SKU to be sold, and seeing as I only need to sell about 200 more, I might not have to wait the full 10 minutes. So we're gonna head over to admin, see what we can sell there. Got 196 SKU left. Look at it, let me sell another 50 of that right there for the same price too as the other place. So hey, that's not bad. Only have 146 left. Like I said, this is usually the time where I will go through my inventory, organize it, go sell any loot I have, go sell med gowns, do whatever, man. Rehydrate, eat something. And then I sell the rest, and I go back out and I do it again. We'll see how much I make here in a second. You just eat your lunch. Have a beer or something. Do I have any beers here? No, I don't have any beers here. Get hydrated. Do some calisthenics, maybe. Alright, so literally 3 minutes after I sold that stuff over at, what do you call it, the admin, I can sell another 47 units, but I'm just gonna wait to sell it all. Is that Anna Demetrio talking? We were honored enough, she was hanging out with the Cobra Force yesterday. It was pretty fun. She's such a nice person. I've enjoyed watching her grow over the last couple of years as a streamer and an actress and voice actor, actress, and yeah, she's voice talent. She's good. She's good people. If you never checked out Anna Demetrio on Twitch or YouTube, I highly suggest you do. I'll put links down below as always. I don't think that's Anna talking though. But she's the voice of the Babbage hologram. If you don't know who I'm talking about, Anna Demetrio's the voice of the Babbage hologram. She's the voice of Sergeant, is it Sergeant Dooley or Captain Dooley? Xenoforce fame. And then she's the woman that comes on your Mobi Glass and tells you, hey, get out there, get back in the fight. Where are you going? She's also the voice of Orison Hospital that you hear over the announcements telling you all kinds of information. I think she voices something in the trams too. But yeah, she's she actually got a part in Squadron 42. Doing something. She can't talk about it, of course. We don't know what she's doing, but she said it was very fun and interesting. She's actually been on Inside Star Citizen as well, talking to Jared Huckleby. Yeah, I'll put a link down below if you never checked out Anna. She's amazing. She's wonderful people. Definitely a must watch on Twitch if you're into streamers. She's also does some singing, but that's not like her main thing. But she's a very good singer as well. I forgot to mention that. Alright, so I sold that 47.
Oh my god, this is taking long.
I'm just kidding. It's not taking long at all. I'm just impatient. I can only sell 5 here. All right, so it's been 6 minutes total since I made my first sale. So here we go. We can sell the rest. Transaction complete. Ship is unloaded. All right, so we have 5,271,969 credits now. We made 179,319 on selling that medical supplies. Took 6 minutes to sell them all once we got to the terminal. And then, so here, let's see how much we made total. Started out, so we're at 5,271,969 minus, we started at 479,318. made 478,000 on that round trip, and that wasn't optimal either because we weren't able to get everything we needed at sale 5. All right, everyone, it took 6 minutes to sell everything. We made 478,787 credits on that round trip. Normally I don't have to stop at two places either direction, so I wouldn't have had, normally I don't stop at Hicks and then Deacon's. Normally I just hit one of the places, I fill all the way up and I run back. And normally I don't have to stop at Sale 2 on the first leg of the journey, but since commodity was scarce there, wasn't able to fill up completely. I probably would have made more money if I was able to get all the barrel I normally get, and I usually get 500 SKU of barrel and 196 SKU of gold. So I would have made easily 500,000 credits if this was a normal run, but you always have those backup options if you need them, which is good. So that's a, you know, half a million one round trip, and then you can just start going doing it again. Is it the best, is it the best cargo shipment run out there? No. I'm just showing you what I do. I do a lot of other places too, but I'm hoping this little route you can add to your repertoire or into your, whatever you do on your runs. But hey, if you got a C2, even a Caterpillar, you could probably make close to what I made. But if you got a C2 and you want to make half a million round trip, there you go. Imagine doing that trip 4 times a day. You got almost 2 million credits right there. Every day. That's all it takes. And if you could get in there, get one delivery or one pickup, not have to make 2 stops at one, to get one pickup, you know, you're doing it even faster. I spent roughly an hour doing this, and that's because I had to film it. But normally I'm just running and going. And normally I don't have to make 2 stops, but you got that backup plan too. All right, people, I'm going to put a link to Anna Demetrio down below. Check out Cobra TV. He's awesome. He just posted a new thing on YouTube. He's taking a break from Twitch for a couple days, but check him out anyway on Twitch. Give him a follow. Give him a like. Give me a like. Give me a follow. I really need some subs. We got to get to 1,000 subscribers, man. We're getting close. Thank you to everyone for helping me get past 700 subscribers. I appreciate it. You guys are the best. I love you guys. You're amazing. If you got a better route, throw it down below if you want to share it with people. Most cargo runners don't want to share their routes, and I understand that. I don't share all my routes either, but this little route I thought I'd share with everybody. What else is going on? That's it. We're out of here. I talk a lot. But I want to thank you guys. You really are the best guys in the world. I'm going to give you guys and ladies a salute. I appreciate you all. I think I'm going to start doing some mining soon. I haven't done any mining in a long time. Probably been 2 years. I'm thinking about buying a prospector. And getting back into that, so much stuff has changed in mining. So we'll see. Cyber War, I'm signing off. Here's a salute for you guys. Bum ba da da. Yeah, you guys rock. Bum ba da da. Oh yeah. All right, let's get in here. Let's get in here, followers. Let's do it.
800 subs, man. Throw a sub down below. It's free. You don't have to do nothing. Just gotta click the little button, and everything'll be okay. Oh my God, I'm moving so much. The camera's freaking out. All right, I'll see you guys later. Love you guys. Out.